Hello. Chat, today we have to settle an important argument that has torn apart our society for far too long. What are the most important household appliances, and if you were to put them in a tier list and rank them against each other, where would they go and how would they rank? Would they rank stuff? I don't know. Let's find out. We are going to find out today on today's video. This was from our 18-hour rebrand / sub goal stream, which was a huge event on Twitch. It was a ton of fun. I hope you guys enjoy this clipped down highlight VOD. Minimal editing because I think it's just beautiful content on its own. It was a ton of fun. We were just chilling, chatting, having a wonderful time arguing and discussing, and I hope that you enjoy. And if you'd like to do your own tier list, feel free to submit it to me on Discord. We have a whole channel for it. I'd love to explain to you how your opinions are so wrong and my opinions are so right. So if you need me to educate you on why you're wrong and dumb, I'm here for you. I got you. As always, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and ring the bell if you want more content. And as always, I will catch you guys in the next video. Have a beautiful day, week, life, whatever, because you deserve it. Love your beautiful faces. Bye-bye. I want to do this one. I want to rank common household appliances because I think the world needs to know. The world needs to know. We need to rank these based on, I guess, a multitude of things, right? How useful are they? How important are they? Do you use them every day? How much do they improve your life as a whole? How hard would it be to live without them? A variety of different criteria to rank in place what is the ultimate household appliance. Shower should be S tier. Shower is an astoundingly good appliance. Absolutely, hands down. Toilet, indoor plumbing. Couldn't live without it. I'd rather be out back of my house cooking over a wood fire every night than go without a fucking running toilet, all right? Honestly, toilet over shower too. As long as I can shit in a toilet in my own house, I'll go fucking bathe in the river if I needed to, all right? I'd go bathe in the river on a monthly basis like it's 1821 if I could still shit indoors in a toilet. Well, let's go through some lame-os here. First of all, a shredder. This is not a household appliance, this is an office appliance. As an office appliance, it's pretty good, but this is household appliances. You're on the wrong list. Why would I need a shredder in my home? That's dumb. I could just rip stuff up, stupid. I have a shredder. Well, not gonna say anything about you, but I'm just gonna say, wow, all right, you know. Landline, Omega lol. Yeah, landline. Out of date, nobody has you. I've literally not had a landline in my life since I moved out of my parents' house almost a decade ago. Landlines are so dead that it has been a decade of my life without one. You think I won't call your grandma and tell her that her shredder's fucking dumb? I'll call her. DM me her phone number. I'll call her right now, dude. I have a landline too. Hext is 100 years old, confirmed. Confirmed he's 100 years old. What else do we have in here? Mixer. Mixers are bad. Most people buy mixers and they use them twice and then they never use them again. Like, they just sit around, they take up counter space, they collect dust, they become a trophy, a symbol of your laziness. A constant idol located on your kitchen counter saying, "Hey, dummy, remember when you thought you were gonna get into baking? Remember when you watched all of the Great British Bake Off over the course of a week and a half, and then you really swore to yourself that you were gonna get really good at baking, and then maybe one day you would go on the Great British Bake Off, so you spend $250 on a professional level mixer, and then you used it twice, and you literally haven't touched it in a year and a half?" Just saying, dude. Just saying. A hot plate is a little bad, right? Because you should only ever in your life be using a hot plate if you don't have access to a stove. And also, they've got to be like one of the most dangerous fucking things on the planet. How many fires a year do you think get started because of a hot plate? I'm gonna guess like upwards of at least like let's say 10% of household fires are probably, well, dorm room fires are probably started because of negligent hot plate use. Standing mixers are the highest pog, and I despise you for not thinking so. Look, none of you use them, all right? My sister uses it, my mom uses it, but none of you use it. I don't use it. I would never use one. I use a portable induction stove at work like 30 times a day. Is that a hot plate? A portable induction stove. This? It's a little bad, dude. It's a little bad, but no, hear me out, right? Here's why it's a little bad, right? Because a stove is great. You would never use this over a stove. You would never voluntarily use this when you could use a stove. How about the hot plate? But space heaters are caused at least 2 to 3 fires last year around here. Yeah, space heaters be dangerous as fuck, dude. People just like throw clothes and blankets on them and shit. You don't have AC in the kitchen? Yeah, like I didn't have AC in like the working kitchen. Don't want to be in the kitchen. That's not comparable. This is a household appliance list. Everything we're talking about is in the context of a home, not a work, not a professional kitchen. This is in the context of a home. If this was in the context of anywhere in the world, then the shredder and the landline would be slightly higher because for a business, they're very useful. They are great at home. They're not great at home. Just use the oven, bro. Just use your oven, forehead. A tub. Honestly, tubs are good. I prefer showers. Quicker, cleaner, more convenient, but I can respect the tub. A refrigerator? Right up there with stove. Honestly, better than oven. And here's why. Again, I would rather be outside cooking every meal over either like an open campfire or even just using charcoal in a grill. As long as I could keep my food cold in the refrigerator, dude. Fridge freezer is S. Honestly, yeah, it's full S. It's full S tier. You're totally right. I'll put it right up there with fucking the toilet, dude. I still think, like, shitting inside... Like, I've been to a lot of camps. I've shit in a lot of outhouses. Let me tell you, I have pooped in a lot of outhouses. And not only does it suck, if outhouse was your main form of shitter... You have to, like, clean it. You have to maintain it. You gotta take all the shit out of it. That's a whole bunch of That's a lot, dude. There are branching repercussions of not having indoor toilets. Just squat and trowel. Aw, dog, sometimes I wanna relax a little bit. Like, you know, sit down. Let some spiders crawl on my forehead while I try and take a shit in the world's scariest outhouse. What else do we got in here? Air conditioning? Air conditioning is great. Modern life. Again, I don't mind cooking over a fire or with charcoal and like cast iron, like Dutch ovens. I've done it a lot. It's not that big of a deal. I could totally do it more. You know, and if every home had like a fireplace and you had to cook like over the fireplace, I could do that too. Like it wouldn't be that big of a deal. Like it would suck. It's definitely a great thing. Worst part about outhouse, one ply. Dude, you gotta bring your own toilet paper to the outhouse, man. When I go camping, I always bring toilet paper, whether we're going backpacking in the deep woods, or even if we're just going to a normal-ass campground, go into the bathroom before you leave, fucking do this hand wrap, get a nice handful of toilet paper, pop that bitch off, and you put that shit right in your camping bag. Ceiling fan? I'm gonna go with, like, middle range, you know? I don't have ceiling fans in this house at all, and it's not that big of a deal. I wish we did. I do miss the ceiling fan we used to have outside on the upstairs because it was good for circulation. But, like, let's be honest. If you've got good AC, the ceiling fan doesn't need to do any work. You don't need the ceiling fan if the other things are doing their work. And a stand-up fan automatically has to be lower than a ceiling fan. Ceiling fan is better than a standing fan. I do, obviously... have not that exact style, but a standing fan back there. Imagine having AC. Do you not have AC? Do you live in a hotel? No, I live in a part of the world that gets up to like 90 to 100 degrees in the summer. It gets fucking hot, dude. It's Europe, dude. Yeah, you live really far north compared to me. I am much closer to the equator than you are. Standing fan is a S tier in my book. You need it to help sleep. Okay, shit. He does bring up a good point, because I'm thinking like a fan like this, but if we assume that this fan is the same as like this fan, as this kind of like orbital fan, which is good for sleeping and air circulation, I still think ceiling fan is better though. I'm gonna do this. I think the ceiling fan is better. Ceiling fan can also provide a little like white noise, dude. It had 120 degrees Fahrenheit for a few years, no AC. Heat stroke and cheap beer. Yeah, but that sounds miserable. It sounds like you're literally complaining about it right now. Wouldn't you rather have had AC? All I'm saying is I feel like you guys are agreeing with me that the AC is super useful. You're like, I was here and it was miserable. I was here and it was more miserable. You know what? Sounds like you could have used a little bit of air conditioning in your life is all I'm saying. All I'm saying is it comes back down to, I feel like we're all kind of on the same page here. Coffee maker is great for me. I use my coffee maker literally every single day. Every single day of forever, I use my fucking coffee maker all the fucking time. PC is fucking astounding. Honestly, I trade everything else away to still have PC. Like, my PC is like, dude, it's my TV, it's my gaming system, it's my, like, work. It's my stream, it's my, you know, it's my friendship, it's my communication with people. It's everything. It's everything and it can do everything. I would take it over an actual toilet. Literally, if you were like, all right, you can have toilets or you can have a PC. I'm choosing the PC every time. I'm sorry, but the minute-to-minute convenience of owning a PC versus everything else in my life is like, I just use this the most. Nothing else can stack up to it. Nothing else even comes remotely close. Also, toaster oven. Toaster oven's great, dude. I use the toaster oven almost as much as I use the regular stove. Actually, that's probably not true. I probably use the toaster oven more than I use the stove. It's amazing. I'll use this to cook, but then I'll use this to reheat everything. Standalone freezer is middle range. Like, I've never had one. They seem convenient. Actually, that's not true. I lived in a house with one, and it seemed dumb. If you have, like, a family of probably, I don't know, what, like, five, six, seven people? I don't know how big your family needs to be to justify having a separate freezer when every refrigerator also already has a freezer. I just feel like standalone freezers are exorbitant. They're ritzy. They're ritzy, and I don't need it, dude. Ironing board is kind of bad. It's dumb. I used to have one for work, but it's dumb. I assume this is like iron in ironing board. It's kind of bad because anytime I gotta use one, I'm doing something I don't want to do. I've never had to use an ironing board and then gotten in the car and then driven somewhere I wanted to go. That's literally never happened to me ever in my entire life. What else do we got? Blender, meh, middle range. I don't really use a blender. Dishwasher is good, but pretty unnecessary, honestly. A boombox, like an actual like CD player boombox, is pretty god-awful. Super horribly out of date. Comically out of date at this point. Okay, so this is a stove and this is an oven. Those just go right together. That's easy. Microwave is pretty good. Microwave is pretty good. Actually, I'll put microwave at the end of the great category. All of the like food prepping things are great. I could live without them if I had to, but I would get rid of everything below it first. I would wash my own dishes, I would have no fans, I would get rid of blenders, hot plates, freezers, and all this garbage. All of this would go straight in the trash if I could keep all of my cooking utensils. Dude, honestly, I'm not a 90-year-old grandma, so I'm gonna say sewing machine, it's bad, alright? First of all, like, I could just, like, hand sew most stuff. In the year 2020, I feel like sewing is going the way of the birds, man. I've lived most of my life without a dishwasher, and I could go back to it if I needed to. It's great to have. I love the convenience, but, like, I don't need it, man. If I have the PC, I don't really need the TV as much, though. Right? Rice cooker, I'm gonna put in the good category as well. No, honestly, I'm gonna put it in the... I'm gonna put it right here. Right in the middle of the good category. Alright, I'd rather have a dishwasher and a TV than a rice cooker. But a rice cooker is solid. I don't even know what this thing is. What is this thing? I don't even know what this is, so it must not be good. If I don't even know what it is, it's automatically gotta be garbage. That's Insta cooker, the other is rice cooker. Wait, what? You eat rice if you don't have a rice cooker, you shouldn't eat rice. I do respect that. I respect that a lot. Washing dishes, I've done entire shifts washing dishes at my old job too. It's fucking miserable. I'm gonna make macaroons and shit, dude. Macaroons sound so good. That is an air fryer. I don't think that's an air fryer. Pressure cooker, that's the rice cooker. You guys see that every single one of you put in a different answer as to what it is, right? You guys, literally every one of you said something different than the other one. My grandma had a bread maker, was pretty legit. Look, I'm never gonna make bread, so I think it's dumb. Honey's good in Instapot, the one is god awful is rice cooker. This looks like my rice cooker. This looks like my rice cooker. And this looks like a bread maker. So that's what I'm gonna go with. That's what we're gonna say they are. That's how we're ranking them. A lamp! Lights in your home. Pretty useful, because we don't have ceiling lights in my house, so having lights is honestly pretty fucking astounding. Having lights is a major convenience. It would be tough to have your house without lights. You'd have to go to bed so early. Every night it got dark, you'd just be done. It's not a crock pot either. It's definitely not a crock pot. Actually, astounded and disappointed to see crock pot not on this list. I would put crock pot right behind coffee maker if it was on the list. Crock pot would go right here. It would be right here. Toaster. I don't really need a toaster if I got a toaster oven. I just toast all my bread in the toaster oven. It's got a toaster built right into it. It is a toaster. It's better than a normal toaster. You're just a toaster oven, but mine is so much functionality. Save money on electricity and use cheap candles. Is that actually cheaper though? Like, first of all, candles suck. They're not bright at all. But like, on top of that, how many candles would I have to buy a month to replace my electricity bill? I feel like, I don't know if I would actually save money. It's perfect for Spooktober. The candles? Eh. Alright, what else you got? Waffle maker is middle range. Waffle maker, great to use a waffle maker. Who doesn't love a waffle maker? Like, obviously a waffle maker is fucking amazing, but like, how often do you really use it? How often is a waffle maker relevant to my life, dude? It looks like a shit waffle maker. It's not about the specific model. All right, it's about the concept of waffle makers as a whole. Washer and dryer obviously gonna go right next to each other. They're both astounding, honestly. They're both fucking astounding. They're better than lights, honestly. They're better than... That's a tough one. Maybe they're not better than AC. I don't think they're better than AC. Dryers. I guess dryers aren't technically as useful as a washer because you could hang your clothes up outside. Why buy a plaid pancake maker when you could just make a regular pancakes on a pan? What the fuck did you just say to me, bro? Did you just fucking insult waffles like that right to my fucking face in my chat? Waffles are the far superior breakfast food to pancakes. Pancakes, not crispy, all right? Just shitty syrup sponges. Waffles, they're not shitty syrup sponges, all right? They have beautiful individual containment receptacles for waffles. They have the maximum amount of surface area of crispy waffleness, though. It is the maximum possible potential surface area for crisp to syrup ratio, all right? It's a perfect, masterful meeting of engineering and delicious food, all right? It is a food that is the smartest food in the world. What about crepes? Crepes are pretty good. How am I gonna rate this sink? The sink, I mean, it's pretty useful. Running water, super useful. The ability to wash dishes. It's not an S tier. Think about their prosperity delivered dishwash is required for life. I mean, I'd rather have a sink than just have, like, a dishwasher. You need the sink for so much stuff, though. Water, rinsing out. You can't even use this without this. Because you have to rinse off your food. You have to, like, rinse off your plates and stuff in the dishwasher. There. I'm gonna put it here at the end of the great tier list. If it's not S tier, think about their propensity to deliver dish water, which is required for life. Yes. I'm gonna put it here. I mean, I could get water out of the shower if I just had a shower, right? But I need the sink for some other utilities. Pretty much all of the, like, necessary cooking shit is right here. All of the cooking shit is great. These things are astounding, dude. Computer, astounding. Toilet, astounding. Keeping food refrigerated, making it last multiple, fridge and freezer combo especially. Amazing. You can keep food for months at a time as opposed to days. Shower. Love it. Don't have to bathe in the river. Air conditioning. Makes my whole life better. Washing machine and dryer. Again, I don't want to have to spend so much of my life hand washing clothes on, like, in a washing basin and hanging them out to dry. Having lights in your home. Fucking stellar, dude. This is what makes up a convenient life, alright? I would honestly, cooking and cleaning dishes outside, not that big of a deal. Wouldn't want to do it by choice, but could do it if it came down to it. Just use your phone flash if you need a light. No, dude. No. Hell no. Vacuum cleaner. It's kind of middle range, right? Some people need it, some people don't need it. It's not really that important. I mean, it's nice to have clean floors, so it's definitely okay. I would definitely go without it over a lot of other things. There's other ways to clean the house. Check Discord. Oh, here it is. It's a 5-cup brown stainless rice cooker with built-in timer. Okay, well then you know what? It'll be a little bad then, because this is a pressure cooker. I have this and I cook rice in it all the time, is all I'm gonna say. So if this is just like, if this cooks rice and other stuff and this just cooks rice, then like it's dumb, right? Then it's dumb. I don't need it then. It doesn't serve a purpose. It doesn't make any sense. It's silly. It's dumb. Okay, last and kind of least, honestly, is a heater. Are we saying this is a space heater or like a heating in general? Because if it's literally, you piece of shit. Literally, if it's just a fucking like space heater, then it's a little bad. It's like, this is like only for rich people. This is kind of only for broke people, to be honest with you. Trust me, I've been there. I've had space heaters in shitty apartments that don't heat well. I've never really used the hot plate because we weren't allowed to have one in college, but I wish I'd had one. It looks like a dryer. This is a space heater for sure. This is my list. I like how it goes down. Like this, so many things are astounding. These things are just dumb. Dumb and outdated. The god-awful tier is just like, don't need it, don't want it, fuck it, it's so dumb, whatever. The bad tier is like, I could see some people using it, but I don't use it, and therefore it's dumb to me. Little bad is like, in very specific circumstances, these could be useful, but in general, like, there's better options. Kind of the same for middle range, like, there's a lot of better options for these things. Like, honestly, toaster oven's a little bad. Or sorry, regular toaster's a little bad compared to toaster oven. Blender has a purpose. Fan, vacuum, these things all have purposes. Waffle maker, excellent at what it does, but just way too niche, dude. Way too niche. What else we got? Yeah, and then all the cooking stuff makes my life way easier. All of this makes my life way easier. I gotta be honest, I feel like I'm overvaluing washer and dryer by a lot. I feel like washer and dryer are probably more along like these lines. They're a little more here. I think they're more in the good tier. I think that's more fair. Astounding, PC, yep, toilet, yep, refrigerator, freezer, yep, shower, yep, AC, yep, and lights, hell, yep. That's it, dude. That's my list, baby. I'm gonna save it, clip it, ship it, download it, send it over to the Discord. We got it, dude. When I was like 3 or 4, me and my sister all got a Philips TV VHS combination. Dude, my parents would not let me have a TV in my refrigerator, in my room, until I was like 14. I begged them constantly. They did not break down until I was like 14, and it was booger shit.